evening, everybody. This is how we make it. This is not the end class. Hope you can hear me. I hope you can see this light. I hope you also enjoy the music. Let me give you a few more seconds to just listen to the music and then also get started. Thank you, everybody. I'm so glad that I'm here today. I promise you, I have been on break for a couple of weeks for my online class. Understanding the spiritual laws of man. All right, so just confirm you can see me, you can see this light, and then you can also hear the class. I'm going to stop the music in the next couple of seconds.
Love you every day and night.
All right, so thank you once again, and welcome to today's class. My name is Dr. J. Ubu, and I'm so glad to have you in tonight's class. Now, a couple of people are already raising up their hands. Everybody is on mute, so we can have a very smooth and quiet class. So if you have any comments, if you have any concerns, please kindly use the chat box. Type your question, type your comments on the chat box, and then I'm going to, from time to time, look at the chat box to address the concerns you have raised, okay? All right, good, fantastic. So please, let's start with introductions. We're a couple of minutes down the hour. So let's start with introductions. I'd like to get to know you, so let me know your name. Use the chat box. Let me know your name. Let me know where you're joining me from. Are you in Enugu? Are you in Abuja? Are you in Lagos? Are you outside of Nigeria? Let me know where you're joining us from. And then also let me know whether this is your first time of joining my online class. The class is getting filled up. Quite a whole lot of people are already beginning to join. So let the introduction start. Three things: your name, your physical location, where you're joining me from, and then whether this is your first time or you are my student and then you've been joining my class before now. I have a reason for that, because I have a special gift for all those who are joining me for the first time today. I have a special gift for all of you. Then for everybody that stays to the end of the class, I'm going to have another special gift I want to give you if you stay till the end of the class. All right, Junior Precious from Abuja, this is her first time. All right, Shedrack Aldukada from Gombe, okay, not your first time, meaning you've been in my class once or twice before. Ifeima from Abuja, an old student. Oh, fantastic. This is great. So please kindly let introductions come in as we get the class started. All right. Good. So today we're going to be looking at understanding the spiritual laws of money. And then why I needed to deal with this is because, you know, a lot of people, based on what is going on, of course, COVID-19 is still here. It is not completely over, but we understand the effects are still with us. You know, a lot of people are yet to recover. And most importantly, what has been affected is our finances. So we need to deal with those finances. Mr. Kenneth is joining us from Lagos, and then he says it's the second time. All right, fantastic. So, and then I needed to let us understand, because in this period that I've been off social media, you know, I had a project I've been working on, you know, physically. So I've interacted with a lot of people, and I find that people keep struggling for money. People keep looking for money. People keep trying to pursue money, to get money. And unfortunately, there are laws that guide the acquisition of money, and then most of these laws are spiritual. You know, spiritual is intangible, but people are looking for the tangible thing, which is money. Unfortunately, money is a shadow. That is a substance that controls money, and then it's only when you can get hold of that substance that you can get hold of the shadow. The shadow is money. I'm going to talk about it as we proceed. Now, please make sure you have your pen and paper to write, because it's important. There are so many things I'm going to be discussing with you today that a lot of you are going to be hearing that for the very first time. Mr. Kama is joining us from Ileife. Wow, that is Shane City of Ileife. It's the first time. Fantastic. You're welcome to the class. Please do write this down. poor men pursue money. Poor men pursue money. And I've just said it, money is a shadow. Wealthy men create value and then attract money. Okay? Poor men do what? They pursue money. Man, the money is a shadow. It's only mad men that pursue money. Yes, you got me right. It's only mad men that do what? They pursue shadows. But what wealthy men do is what? They create value. And then once you create value, then money is attracted to that value. Okay? So I know a lot of us need money for one thing or the other, for several things. I'm not going to go into the details of that. But this is very, 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 very important. Okay? All right. Betty Samuel from Ibadan is joining us again for the first time as well. Okay? So again, laws. We need to look at laws. You understand? Because you see, laws are unchanging principles. They are unchanging principles that guide every activity. Every result you see in life is guided by laws. I'm actually sitting in a building. This building is here because it's obeying certain laws. There are laws that the architects and the builders had to obey for this building to be stable. It's actually a high-rise building. Do you understand? Now, the same thing is applicable to money. There are laws guiding money. If you don't understand those laws and then deliberately obey those laws, then you're going to be in a lot of trouble. It doesn't matter how much you need money. It doesn't matter how hard you work. Let me tell you this. Life does not reward you according to the extent of your hard work. Life rewards you according to the accuracy of your definitions. Okay? Good or good. I hope you're following what I'm saying. So it is important to understand that laws, there are laws, and then I'm going to talk about spiritual laws today. Now, let me give you an instance. If there's a universal law called the law of gravity. And now, just to make it in a layman's understanding, the law of gravity says that whatever goes up must come down, which means that if I throw this ballpoint pen up, it must come down. Why? Because of the law of gravity. Now, it means that in this building where I am taking this class, if you go to the last floor and then maybe jump from that place, if you fall to the ground, you're going to, because of the force of gravity, you're going to break your bones, your legs, and then whatever it is. You probably may even die in the process. Now, let me tell you, that's a law of gravity. Now, that law does not care whether you're an adult or whether you're a child or whether you know that there's a law of gravity in operation. As long as you climb to that last floor and jump from there, that law of gravity must take effect. So what it means is this: whether you know about the spiritual laws of money or not, if you don't deliberately obey them, then the consequences are going to apply. In law, they say that ignorance of the law is not an excuse, but obviously this also applies. Okay, good or good. So that's just the basic foundation. You know, I needed to let you understand, you know, what it says. Okay, fantastic. Mr. Nelson Kingsley is joining us for the very first time, all the way from the city of Enugu. All right, so today we're going to try to cover quite a whole lot. I'm going to look at how to prosper despite adversity, and that's the cross of the spiritual laws of money. Then I'm going to share with you three thriving businesses you can start now, you know, irrespective of what it is you're doing, irrespective of where you are. And then thirdly, we're going to look at how to adapt your business for consistent income generation despite the lockdown. So cumulatively, in summation, we hope that at the end of this training, you should be able to acquire the knowledge, the understanding, skills, and competence that will enable you to thrive financially despite the COVID-19 crisis. And then I'm going to take a breather to explain a bit of those things. Now, the class is already ongoing, so you need to make sure that you're writing some of these things down, because these are points that are going to help you take your business, take your finances to a totally new, different level. Let me start with knowledge. Now, you see, in Proverbs 24, verse 3, it says, "For by knowledge shall the chambers be filled with all precious and pleasant riches." Now, you see, that's again part of the law I'm talking about. You see, knowledge is your awareness of an information that makes you better than who are not aware of that information. That's the meaning of knowledge. It's derived from two Greek words, know and then edge. Now, know is awareness. Edge is like, you know, something that makes you better, a better position. So knowledge is the information you're aware of that makes you better than another person. Now, a lot of us are not aware of this kind of information we're sharing today. A lot of us are not deliberately bringing themselves into awareness of the laws guiding the practice of any kind of business they do. All they do is that they wake up in the morning and then they want to make money. It doesn't work like that. Okay, so again, that's why the scripture says, "For by knowledge shall the chambers be filled with all precious and pleasant riches." So if you desire pleasant riches, if you desire precious riches, what do you need? Is knowledge. But that knowledge is not enough. Knowledge is the beginning, is what you're aware of that gives you an advantage. But there's another level that is called understanding. 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 You may have knowledge, but you don't have understanding. And understanding is what you get from practice. It is in the application of the knowledge that you get what understanding. For instance, you're setting up a business, you're doing maybe events, you're doing catering, you're doing, you run a shop where you sell phones and all of those things. You see, it's when you get the knowledge and apply it, the understanding comes from the application of knowledge, okay? So when you have information and you don't go ahead to apply it, you will not understand. And it's commonly said that you can never understand what you are not involved in, okay? Now, what I'm trying to break this down is, I'm going to give you information tonight, I'm going to give you knowledge, but until you put into actual practice the things I'm discussing with you today, it will never translate into understanding. And then another dimension is skills. What is skill? Skill is the ability to execute a task. That's what skill is, the ability to execute it. That's, for instance, I'm teaching, I'm a teacher now, I'm a consultant. What it means is I have the skill to teach. I can execute a task. As a doctor, of course, I'm going to introduce myself shortly. As a doctor, I have the skill of medical practice, which means if you come to the hospital, I can do surgery for you, I can prescribe drugs for you, and you get better. So that's skill. Do you have, question is this, do you have skill? Do you have financial knowledge? Do you have financial understanding? Then you have the skill of making money. You see, these things are guided by principles and by laws. If you don't follow them, you are going nowhere. And then what is competence? Competence is a higher level of skill. Competence is the ability to execute a task backed by an understanding of the theory behind the execution of the task. Okay? I hope we're not too fast. If we are, please kindly let me know. I'm trying to make sure there's a whole lot I need to cover today. But if I'm too fast, let me know so I can slow down a bit. All right, so what did we say? Competence is the ability to execute a task backed by an understanding of the theory or the principle or the philosophy behind the practice or the execution of that task. So skill is a lower dimension. When you have competence, it means you have skill and then you also have understanding of principles. I'll give you an example. Now, the difference between a carpenter and a designer, a furniture designer, is skill and competence. The difference between a bricklayer and a builder and an architect is skill and competence. A bricklayer can put blocks together and then form a house. But an architect has an understanding of why there has to be a pillar here, why there has to be window here, why there has to be window on the other side. That's the understanding. So an architect can draw a building and say, okay, put a window here, put a window here. He measures the dimension, he measures the weight of the building, and then distributes it accordingly and puts pillars in the right place. But a bricklayer would also say, okay, let's put block here. So that's the difference. Skill is not enough. You must get yourself to the level where you have an understanding of the principles. So again, it applies to a lot of us. You have made 1 million, you have made 5 million, but because you don't know the principle, you don't know the philosophy behind that 5 million you make, you cannot make it again. It means you don't have competence. You have the skill to make money, but you don't have competence. Okay? When you have competence, if you make 1 million, it means you made 1 million, but you also know what you did to make the 1 million. So if you want to make another 1 million, you can go back to that same thing you did to make the 1 million again. All right? Good. Fantastic. So where I want to take you to is the point where you don't just have knowledge of money, you don't just have understanding of money, you don't just have skills of making money. You have competence with regards to making money, which means you can make money now, you can make it tomorrow, you can make it next tomorrow. It doesn't matter where you are. As I speak with you now, I'm in the city, in the coast city of Enugu, and then it's been amazing the kind of results we're creating here. I'm actually based in Abuja, but I have to come into Enugu for a project. You understand? But is it respective of what's it called now? Geographical location. Wherever you are, if you have the competence with respect to making money, you will create value and make money wherever you are. Whether it's COVID-19, whether COVID-19 is gone, those are the things that will happen. All right. So I'm going to make sure that we cover a lot of grounds today, but bear it in mind. You need to get knowledge. You need to apply the knowledge to have understanding. Then you need to learn how to execute tasks, which gives you skills. And then you need to understand the reason why you're successful or not successful in the execution of that task, the principles and philosophies guiding that execution, that is what makes you competent. And that only comes from coming for trainings like this. Good. Fantastic. All right. So, well, that's how we do the introduction to the class proper. And then I'm going to start with full force now and show you the things you need to know. Okay. Somebody says, please slow down a bit. Okay. Is that a general consensus that we should slow down a bit? Okay. All right. We'll take it slowly. I'm just trying to be a little bit fast so we can cover all the things that we need to cover. But share with me what we have learned so far. We've been here maybe 20 minutes today, but share with me, type in the chat box. The last 20 minutes, I've explained a couple of things, a couple of principles, laws. Share with me what you have learned already. Type in the chat box. Let me know in the last few minutes, what is it that you have learned that is useful to you? I do this to make sure that we continue to learn. To make sure that the things, you know, you're able to take it down and then assimilate it so that it can make more sense to you. My classes are usually very, very interactive. So please type in the chat box, what have you learned in the last 10, 15 minutes that we've been here? I've explained a couple of things. All right? Good. All right. So for those of you who are joining us for the first time, let me just do a proper introduction. My name is Dr. Jay Ugwu. I'm a medical doctor turned personal finance coach. I'm the founder of the Millionaire Entrepreneurs University. And then I'm an entrepreneurship development and management consultant. I want to tell you the story of my life as you proceed. But, you know, the question I get all the time, okay, if anyone says different between skill and competence, knowledge and understanding. All right, so skill and competence is what? Understanding of the principle. Knowledge and understanding is in practice, right? So like I said, my name is Okoji. I'm actually a medical doctor, retired at the age of 40. And then one of the questions people usually ask me is, you're a doctor, why did you have to leave medical practice? Why did you have to start teaching all of this? Yes, let me tell you the truth. I actually didn't leave medical practice. I still practice. In fact, even today, I had to consult. Yes, I keep consulting. But the truth is this. You know, as a doctor, I was struggling. In fact, way back, you know, like 10 years ago, I was struggling. Things were so difficult. And I was still making money as a doctor. I was still being paid and all of that. But you see, because I didn't understand financial management, I didn't understand these financial principles I am teaching you until sometime in 2012 when I met a coach and mentor who told me the difference between diversification, the difference between different kinds of education. That was when my life took a new turn. For instance, you know, then I was doing business. I was already a doctor. I was doing business, but things were always very difficult for me. So until I understood diversification, diversification is not doing different things in different ways. Diversification is doing one thing in different ways. Okay, Shedak says what he has learned. Stop pursuing money or pursuing knowledge at all costs and add value to the life of other money will follow. Fantastic. I've learned that competency is understanding the difference between skill and knowledge. Okay, that's good. I'm excited. This class is, I have a lot of very intelligent people in this class, all right? So it is important to understand how to diversify. And let me also tell you this, you're not made for any particular thing. For instance, people think, okay, if you're a doctor, you're meant to work in the hospital. And yes, you should, but that doesn't stop you from doing other things you need to do. And then how do you do those things? It is the same virtue that you used to practice as a doctor that you also used to do any other thing that you need to do. But again, before you begin to diversify, you must specialize. Write this down. Before you diversify, you must do what? Specialize, which means you must be an expert in one thing. So for me, for instance, I achieved that expertise as a medical doctor before I could take that same virtues I used to now begin to go into other businesses, right? So as we proceed, I'm going to talk about the principles of diversification and the fact that you can actually do anything if you learn how. Okay, say to yourself, I can do anything if I learn how. So if you're listening to me, if you're an engineer, if you're a doctor, if you're a lawyer, if you're not even a professional, you can do anything if you learn how. You know, let me tell you this. The capacity to learn is a gift given to everybody by God. We can all learn. The capacity to learn is a gift given to us by God. Okay? Now, the willingness to learn is a decision made by different people. So if you make a decision to learn, then you can do anything you want. If you want to make money, for instance, go to Koscharis, go to Innocent, go to Dangote, go to Femi Otedola. These are multi-billionaires. They had the capacity, and then they had a willingness. And then finally, the ability to learn is a skill developed. Okay, so let's take it one after the other. There are three levels now. Capacity to learn is given to everybody by God. So you can learn to be a doctor, you can learn to be a lawyer, you can learn to be a millionaire, you can learn to make money. That everybody has that capacity. But now the willingness to learn is a choice. So you have to make a choice that I want to learn. If you want to be a doctor, it's simple. Make a choice that you want to go and buy jam form and then go to medical school. If you want to be a lawyer, it's the same thing. Go to law school. You want to go be an engineer, go to an engineering school. So you need to make that choice. But the ability to learn is developed, is a skill. Am I making sense? So you need to have capacity. Do you understand? You need to have willingness, and then you need to have what? Ability. So when it comes to making money, remember, this is a business class, so I'm teaching you how to make money. Do you understand? So the capacity to make money, everybody has that capacity. As long as you're a person, a human being, born of a man and a woman and of God, made an image and likeness of God, you have the capacity to make money, and then you have the capacity to become a multi-billionaire. That's true. Your capacity is unlimited. In Genesis 11, I think verse 5 or thereabout, it says, for now there will be nothing that will be restrained to them that they have imagined to do. Remember, Genesis 11 is where they build the Tower of Babel. And then it said, while the children of men were spread along the earth, and then they decided, I'm just paraphrasing now, they decided to build a tower that will reach to the heaven. And then God was actually scared. Well, sorry to use that word, but they were going to build a tower to get to God. And then God said, there is nothing that this could have imagined that would be restrained from them. That's the capacity you have as a child of God. Because in Genesis 1:26, he said, let's make man in our own image and likeness. So you are made in the image and likeness of God. You have the huge potential. But you see, capacity is different from willingness. So until you have the willingness, for instance, every one of us who is in this class now, it is that willingness, that choice you have made to come to this class to learn. But the final level is your ability, which is a skill, which is a competence we are building, we are developing. So with the things I'm going to teach you, it's going to take a number of people now to be able to practice and then develop competence, right? Good or good? Good, good, good. I don't know what brought us here, but I hope it makes sense, right? So please avoid distractions. Make sure you stay to the end. And then, yes, like I said, I'm going to give you a couple of gifts. And then please do write the things you're learning down. Do write the things you're learning down. Yes, he said, I can do anything if I learn how. I can do anything if I learn how. So write it on the chat box. Write it on your notes. I can become a multimillionaire if I learn how. Write it on your notes. Yes. You can become a multimillionaire if you do what? If you learn how. So it doesn't matter your situation currently in life, whether you don't even have money in your bank account, whether you don't even have BVN, you don't even have a bank account, because you're already a child of God, made in image and likeness of God, and then because there's nothing that can be restrained from you, you can become a multimillionaire if you do what? If you learn how. That's where the difference is. You see, a lot of people have faith. I'm going to talk about faith shortly. A lot of people have faith, but you see, because you don't learn how, that is a process, that is a law, there are things you need to follow. If you don't learn how to follow those laws, those principles, then that's your capacity. You're going to die with that potential, right? So say with me, I will not die with my potential. I will influence my generation with my potential. Say with me, I will not die with my potential. I will influence my generation with my potential. And let me tell you this, that's why what I teach is money. I don't miss once about it, because the greatest tool you can use to influence people is money. The greatest tool you can use to change your generation is money. The greatest tool you can use to do good is money. If you don't have money, sorry to say, it's going to be difficult for you to amount to anything. Yes, yes. You see, you must have leverage or one way or the other for you to be able, because money will amplify your capacity to do things, right? You already know we're using a training methodology called NLP. I ask questions, I ask you to do simple exercises, I repeat a few things, and then I use learning aids. I may not be able to play videos for you today. If you're excited already, if you're blessed already in today's class, say I am blessed. Say I am blessed. Type in the chat box, say I'm blessed. If you're already learning something and then you're grateful that you came for today's class, say I am grateful I am in this class. Write it on the chat box. I'm actually reading your comments as I am taking this class. Right? If anyone says I can become a multimillionaire if I learn how, shared access. I will not die with my potential or influence my generation. I'm blessed, I'm grateful. Fantastic, this class is on fire. All right, so let's do one declaration and then I'll show you the spiritual laws of money. Let's do the declaration. Now, for those of you who've been in my class, already know the declaration. We'll call it the millionaire declaration, the millionaire declaration. And then this is how we do it. You put your right hand by the right side of your head and say, I am a millionaire. Follow me and do it. Put your right hand by the right side of your head and say, I am a millionaire. And then that same right hand, put it over the left side of your chest and say, I am awesome. And then give yourself a high five. Did you see me do it? So it's a three-step millionaire declaration. You put your right hand by the right side of your head and say, I'm a millionaire. That same hand, you put it over the left side of your chest and say, I am awesome. And then give yourself a high five. So go ahead and do it. I will explain to you shortly what it means. And then you're going to be doing it for the next 30 days. So that's your first assignment. You're going to be doing the millionaire declaration for the next 30 days. Twice every day, you wake up in the morning, you do your millionaire declaration. Before you go to bed at night, you do your millionaire declaration. Awesome, awesome. This technology is so beautiful. Apple joining me from all parts of the world just in this class. Just have to test to make sure that you can hear me clearly. And then this is amazing, okay? So again, say to yourself, I am a millionaire. I am awesome. And then give yourself a high five. Fantastic. Now, why do you need to speak it? You see, the world was created by spoken word. So everything you see physically out there is created by spoken word. So if you need to create your life, beyond conceptualizing it in your mind, in your head, you need to speak it out. So that is why you must say it. If you want to have money, the importance of this class is money, so I don't miss what's about it. If you want to have money, you must continuously speak to yourself that you're a millionaire. What happens? Each time you speak, you release that energy into the atmosphere, and it's called the law of attraction. So when you say that you're a millionaire, if you speak it in the morning, what happens is as you come out of your house, opportunities to become a millionaire will come before you. And then because you have spoken it, you're also sensitive to it, you will see it when they happen. Okay? Now, somehow the universe will put you in situations where millions are discussed, in businesses that generate millions, because of what just spoke it. God said, let there be light, and there was what? Light. So if you're a child of God, you must also act like your father. Do you understand? They say, by their fruits you shall know them. So if your father is God, and God created everything by speaking, you have that same power to do what? To speak. Do you understand? You know, people are saying, we the poor masses of Nigeria. And then that's who you become. Do you understand? There are tax situations that, you know, perpetuate poverty in your life, right? So let's not do too much about that. Then when you speak, you attract, okay? And then you create. You attract positive energy to make those things happen in your life. Then when you say you're awesome, it means you're going to do good things. You're going to do honest things. You're going to do genuine things. You're not going to scam people to make money. You're not going to lie to make money. You're not going to cheat people to make money. You have to make money in an awesome way. That is why you're speaking to your heart, okay? And then finally, you give yourself a high five. It means you're going to celebrate yourself, because when you have a vision, people may not believe that you're a millionaire. For instance, you borrowed data to join this class, and I'm asking you to say that you're a millionaire. So people that you borrowed the money for will laugh at you when you say you're a millionaire. So it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter who laughs at you. The important thing is, what are you speaking to yourself? What somebody says about you is not as important as what you say to yourself. Now, what somebody says about you only becomes important when you adopt that thing that they have said to you and then own it. So when somebody tells you that you're poor, and then you feel bad about it, and then you begin to look at yourself as if you're poor, that is when that thing happens to you. Do you understand? all right, let's proceed. So please make sure you do the declaration. In fact, if you've done the declaration, write it on the chat box in the millionaire, I am awesome, and then give yourself a high five. All right, so let me share with you the spiritual laws of money now. So write in the chat box if you have done the millionaire declaration, and then if you're going to do it for the next 30 days. So please do write it in the chat box, and then let's proceed. This is your video. You must make sure you do it so I can see you, right? Okay. So how do you thrive despite the adversity? I'm going to quickly rush through this so that we get to the spiritual laws of money, because I know that's why a lot of you are here. But while I'm speaking, please type it in the chat box I'm a millionaire, I am awesome, and then give yourself a high five. And then make up your mind. That's what we'll talk about, knowledge and understanding, and then skills and competence. You see, the difference, again, between skill and competence, I didn't tell you just to say, I'm a millionaire, I am awesome, and give yourself a high five. I explained to you why you need to do it. The purpose of speaking, the purpose of saying I'm awesome, and the purpose of giving yourself high five, that is what competence. So skill is that you can say to yourself, I'm a millionaire, I'm awesome, and give yourself a high five. That's a declaration. That is skill. But competence now is that you understand why you need to do that. So you can actually adapt it to suit yourself. You can change it. When you understand it, you can change it, right? Okay, good, good, fantastic. I'm a millionaire, I am awesome. I'm plenty of millionaires in this class. All right, so three things quickly that you need to do. Please do write them down. Three things quickly that you need to do for you to be able to thrive despite this adversity. Number one, are we good? All right, so number one is to develop a positive mindset. Develop a positive mindset. And you see here, this is one of the things that, you know, people use that as a cliche. Develop a positive mindset. It's not a cliche. There are things you need to do to be able to develop a positive mindset. And one of the things you understand if you're in a class is, I give you practical steps to achieving anything that I teach you. So I can't just tell you to go and develop a positive mindset. No, now that's not enough. You've heard it long, you know, a lot of time. So what do you need to do? Verbal programming, modeling, and then incidents. Those are the three ways to develop a positive mindset. Now, I may not talk about them today, but let me just explain to you what is mindset. Mindset is from two words, mind and set. Now, mind, of course, is your mind. I'm going to talk about it. Mind is the part of your soul that harbors information, that harbors your thoughts, is the part of your soul. There are so many things I need to teach you today. Let me say, okay, your soul is made up of three parts. A man, in the first place, is made up of three parts or three components. That's the tripartite nature. You are a spirit, you have a soul, and then you live in a body. Hopefully, I'll be able to get to that point. But let's deal with the soul. The soul has three dimensions. The soul has three parts. You have the mind, you have the emotion, and then you have the will. The soul has three dimensions, the mind, the emotion, and the will. So the mind is the repository of your thoughts. So all your thoughts and your mind. Your emotion is the repository of your feelings. So your feelings are what? In your emotion. Do you understand? Then your will is the center of what? Decision. So let's take it slowly now. Your mind is the center of reasoning because it has your thoughts. Now, your emotion is the center of feelings because it has your emotions, right? And then your will is the center of decisions. Now, it's your mind I'm going to talk about now. So, your mindset is the programming of your mind to receive, interpret, and respond to any information. That's what is mindset. It's the programming of your mind to receive, interpret, and respond to a particular any information in a particular way. That's mindset. So if your mind has been set, that set is an engineering word. For instance, if you put concrete, that concrete will set, it means it can change. So your mindset is like a mold. So the information you already have inside of your mind has set your mind in a particular way. So any other information that comes, your mind uses that information to interpret it and then respond in a particular way. This is a bit technical, but you need to understand. For instance, people come and then they see anything online is what scam. That's a mindset. Why? Because of the information they have. People have a mindset, okay, as a doctor, you can't do any other business. That's a mindset. Because of the way they've been trained, people have a mindset, okay, if you want to make money, go to medical school. That's the mindset my father had. Yes. He felt when he was sending me to medical school, he felt he was, you know, building, you know, he wants to make money. Yes, but let me tell you the truth. There are thousands and hundreds of, probably thousands of doctors who are broke. So going to medical school doesn't make you rich. It gives you a skill of medicine, but making money out of the practice of medicine is a different ballgame altogether. All right, let's not get too much about that. So you need to do what? Develop a positive mindset, which means you need to create a new mindset that is different from what you already have. For instance, the office where I'm taking this training now is air conditioned. It means that that air conditioning programs the air inside of this office. So it doesn't matter what is happening outside. Even if outside is hot, this place will be cold. Even if outside is cold, this place will still be cold. That's the same way your mindset is. So depending on the kind of mindset you have, if you have a poverty mindset, even if you're in the midst of billions, you'll still be broke. Yes. If you have a wealthy mindset, even if you're in the midst of lack, you will still be wealthy because you can create wealth out of it, right? So how do you develop a wealthy mindset, a positive mindset? Verbal programming, which is what are the things that people speak that you hear? That's verbal programming. It comes from books, it comes from trainings like this, it comes from people that are around you that do things, the books you read, the trainings you attend. That's verbal programming. Modeling is the way people behave around you. You indirectly copy them, you inadvertently copy them. There's an Igbo adage that if a goat is eating grass, the child or the kid will start looking at the way the mouth of the goat is moving. Over time, that kid learns how to chew grass the same way the mother used to do that. So if your parents are broke, if the people you grew up with are broke, if the people you hang around with now are broke, before you know it, you inadvertently, unconsciously copy their behaviors, copy their attitudes, copy their lifestyle, and then you become like them. So that is why I tell you this, write this down. We are friends, we are relations by blood, but we are friends by choice. We are what? Relations by birth or by blood, but we are friends by choice. So starting from today, make choice of friendship based on your goal, based on your vision in life. It's not because you're living in the same street with somebody. It's not because you're living in the same house with somebody. That person mustn't be your friend. If the person is going where you're going, those are the people that will become your friends. So, but your brothers, your sisters, your parents, you can't choose them. They are there by blood. But your friends should be as a result of what? Choice. What is the determinant of that choice? Your vision and your goal, right? And then, of course, incidencing. Incidences. So incidences are the things that happen to you. So when good things happen to you, it helps you to develop what? A positive mindset. Then of course, you need to create your wealthy place. So creating your wealthy place. Your wealthy place is the intersection of your passion, your skills, and then your market need. And then finally, you need to leverage people, leverage the internet, and then leverage digital markets. So if you can put these three things together, I can assure you that there is no business you venture into that will not succeed. How do you put it together? So develop that positive mindset. Let's say you run a fashion outfit. Do you understand? So develop that positive mindset. Know that you can be successful if you do the right thing. So read books, attend trainings, then have people around your life, whether coaches or mentors or friends, who are exemplifying the kind of lifestyle you desire. Then make big positive things happen to you. Then use that mindset now to run that your business according to your passion, and then develop skills and make sure that your skills meet a market need. Am I making sense? Let me slow down again. Am I making sense? Are you following what I'm saying? Because this is how to get out of this. Right? So you use your positive mindset to create your wealthy place according to your passion. For instance, you may be passionate with dressing, you may be passionate in events, you may be passionate in cake making, you may be passionate in cooking. Do you understand? You need a positive mindset to make that happen. But beyond being passionate about it, do you have the right skills? So if they are looking for somebody to cook, are you the best cook in town? Are you the best cake maker in town? Are you the best dressmaker in town? Are you the best doctor in town? Are you the best trainer? Are you the best consultant in town? Do you have that right skill and then competence? Then can you align your skills to meet with the demand in the market? Okay, for instance, if you're a trainer, if you're a consultant, and then you don't know how to use Zoom, you don't know how to use social media, you don't know how to do digital marketing, then you're not feeding a market need, okay? Are you with me? Now, let me give you another example. You make cake, for instance. Now, look at the current need. Now, because of COVID-19, people may not be doing events the way they used to do it before. But with what is going on now, you can still make cake for people. There is still a demand for cake, but you need to see how people are demanding for cake. So people are doing smaller events, people are doing smaller weddings, people are doing smaller birthday parties. So can you arrange your skills and your passion and your mindset to deliver according to what the market requires now? That's what you need to make money, right? And then of course, leverage. So create collaborations, create partnerships. Do you understand? They say partnerships don't work, but I don't believe so. Partnerships work if you as a person also know how to go about the partnership. Collaborations work if you know how to go about it, right? If you don't have intention of defrauding people, do you understand? Because a lot of times when people come into partnership, they already have an intention of defrauding others, and then the other person defrauds, so you say partnership don't work. No, it's not true. And again, because of that mindset, if you're fearful that something is going to happen to you, most likely that will happen to you. Right? So use the internet and then let's do digital marketing. So those are the three ways you can begin to thrive despite the adversity that we're facing. Whether it's COVID-19, COVID-19 will come and go, but there are still other issues that we need to deal with. Right? Good or good. I'm going to quickly skip this so that we'll fly and get to where I want us to be. Take note. Please rename yourself so I can call you by your name. It says, very well. Yes, yeah, I'm following. All right, so let me know whether you're following me. Let's take another breather. So are you following me? What have you learned so far? Let me know about it. We talked about a whole lot of things. Now we talked about the three things you need to do to be able to thrive despite these economic conditions we have. So let me know in the chat box what you have learned from those three things and then the ones that are applicable to you and then that you can actually begin to apply and then things will begin to change in your life and in your business. Like I said, if you're raising your hand, please use the chat box and type whatever it is that you need to talk to me about, right? And then if you just joined us while I was speaking, please kindly do introduce yourself. Tell us your name, where you're joining us from, and then whether it's your first time or you've been joining my classes before. Right, Mr. Origi Mwabisi, I can see you're writing plenty of things, okay? So that's commendable. As you're writing, please, once in a while, let us know what you're learning so far. So I'm waiting for you in the chat box. Let me know what you have learned so far out of the three ways you can thrive despite COVID-19. I'm sure you can see the slide that is up. So everything depends on your viewpoint. COVID-19 can be bad for you, can be good for you, depending on the way you look at it. And then it is how you look at it that determines what you see. And it is what you see that determines what you do. Do you understand? That's your perspective. So your perspective is derived from two words, pers and then per and spect. Per is a path, spect is to look. Do you understand? So your perspective is the path you're looking at. So you can see these two images. It depends on the path you're looking at. So it depends on the path at which you're looking at the COVID-19. And then the path you're looking at is what will form your concept. That is what will form your actions. And that's what will form what you do. And based on what you do, that's what will determine your result. So if you think you're doomed because of COVID-19, if you think you're doomed because of the economic situation, then of course that's what is going to happen because that's the kind of actions you will take. But if you think, yes, we're not happy with what is going on, people are getting infected and people have died, around the world globally. We're not happy about it. But you can leverage on what is going on to create value for other people and then make money in exchange, right? Remember this, every money you have ever made, every money you ever make is given to you by someone else in exchange for value. Yes, write it down. Every money you have ever made, every money you ever make is given to you by someone else in exchange for a valuable product or service. Right. So it comes back again to people pursuing money. Money is a shadow. We're going to talk about the spiritual laws now. Money is a shadow. So the substance is actually not product. We're going to talk about what the substance is. But at least products and services that are valuable is what attracts money. For instance, I have a bottle of water that I'm drinking. I bought this bottle of water downstairs when I was coming upstairs here. Now, this is money. See, so if you need ₦100, you don't need to pursue ₦100. What you need to pursue is how can I create water and then put it like this so that somebody who has ₦100 will give me his ₦100 in exchange for this bottle of water. And then you start making money. So, it beats my mind when people wake up in the morning and they go looking for money. No, go look for how to create value. Once you create value and package it for products and services, people who have the money will carry their money and look for you. The supermarket where I bought this water, they did not look for me. I was the one that took my money and looked for them and found them and gave them my money and collected the water. So if the woman who owns the supermarket did not create the supermarket, have the water and then put it there, she can be asking for money. She can be praying to God for the rest of her life to bless her with money. But that money is not going to come until she conceptualizes, creates and builds products and services, and then people get money for you or her in exchange. So the same thing is applicable to all of us. If you desire money, we're going to talk about the spiritual laws, but if you desire money, what do you need? Find products and services that you can create that will solve a need, and then people will bring their money to you. Nobody makes money. Everybody earns money. Write this down. Nobody makes money. Everybody earns money. The only people that make money are people that work in the printing and meeting company. And even those people, they don't take the money home. When they finish printing the money, they hand it over to the government. And government pays them salary. So they also earn money at the end of the month in exchange for the services they have delivered in printing the money. So how much less you that don't even work in a bank? How much printing and meeting company? So from today, change your nomenclature. As a matter of fact, write in the chat box, from today, I will stop looking for money. I will start creating valuable products and services. Write this down. I put it on the chat box. From today, I will stop looking for money. I will start creating valuable products and services. From today, I stop looking for how to make money. I start looking for how to earn money by creating valuable products and services. You see, words frame pictures in your mind. And based on the frame that the pictures in your mind have, that is what determines what you do. So when you move, you wake up in the morning and say, I want to get big money. So you're going to start looking for where there is money to collect, to make. It doesn't work like that. That's why a lot of us are frustrated. If you wake up in the morning and say, I want to earn 1 million naira today. Now, your mind changes. What will happen is that your mind will start looking for, because for you to earn money, it means it's an exchange. So for you to earn money, it means you're going to be looking for what you can do to another person so that that person can give you his own money next. That's how to make, how to earn money, right? So, you see, words change a lot of things in our lives. So, you wake up in the morning and say, I want to get big money. We are going to make money. That's rubbish. And that's why you get frustrated. If you wake up in the morning and say, I want to earn money today, it means that your mind is going to begin to look, what will I do to earn this money? Are we making sense? Please let me know. Let me know. Let me know whether we're making sense, what we're teaching is making sense to you, and you're seeing the mistake you're making thus far. Let me tell you the truth. It's not your, the witches and wizards in your village that's preventing you from making money, from earning money. Yes, 90% of the problem is from you. Maybe 10% is from the witches and the wizards. So if you deal with 90%, in fact, the witches and wizards will also even... All right? Yes, I'm not saying witches and wizards do not exist, but a lot of times, we give them too much power. So let's deal with ourselves first. Let's deal with our mindset. Let's deal with the knowledge. Let's deal with the understanding, the competence, and the skills. And then a lot of things will change on their own. Good, all good. Fantastic, fantastic. If anyone says, from today, I'll stop pursuing money. All right, fantastic. So let me know what you have learned in the class so far. Let me know what you have learned in the class so far. Let me know if you're still here, if you're still following me. If the network throws you out, try and come back in. Network throws you out, try and come back in. I can assure you that this is an amazing class. And even me, I've missed this class. I've not had this class for almost a month now. And I felt somehow because I need to deliver value. Right? From today, I'll think of how to make money. No, I said from today, I'll think of how to earn money. So from today, I'll stop thinking of how to make money. I'll start thinking of how to earn money. That's what I explained. Stop looking for how to make money. Start looking for how to do what? Earn money. I create value in exchange for money. All right. So let's deal briefly now with the spiritual laws of money. I'm going to break this class in parts. So I'm not going to end this class today. I'm going to see how much you can take because I need to end within a particular time. I'm going to see how much you can take from the class today. Then next week, we're going to continue. By God's grace, I'm going to be doing this either Tuesday or Thursday. So those of you who are following me on social media or on my email system or WhatsApp groups and all of that, I'm going to let you know that this class is going to be holding either Tuesday or Thursday. But I'm going to try to make sure that I hold this class once every week by 5 p.m. So if depends on my engagement, I can do it on Tuesday, like today is Tuesday. So next week is either I will do it on Tuesday 5 p.m. or Thursday 5 p.m. But I'm gonna try by God's grace to make sure that we'll do this class every week. And of course it's absolutely free. You're not paying money. You didn't pay money to come here, you know, because I know that freely have we received and then freely shall we give. All right. So if you're blessed, let me know in the chat box if you've been blessed and let me know what you have learned. From today, I'll stop looking for money, but create value in exchange for money. All right, so before I just discuss, let me just mention this to you. What is money? This is not part of the class, but I just wanted to let you know, since we are discussing the laws of wealth creation. What is money? Now, write this down. Life does not reward you according to the extent of your hard work. No. Life does not reward you according to the extent of your hard work. Life rewards you according to the accuracy of your definitions. You heard me right. Life does not reward you according to the extent of your hard work. Life rewards you according to the accuracy of your definitions. So what you need to do in life is to define things more accurately. Why is that important? You see, let me tell you this. Life is not physical. Life is more spiritual than it's physical. And it's more mental. I'm going to talk about that shortly. Now, you see, if money, if success is about hard work, then the wheelbarrow pushers will be the most successful. If success is about hard work, then the people who carry blood at the sides will be the richest and the wealthy. But it doesn't work like that. Life rewards you according to the accuracy of your definition. And that's why I take that every concept I come across, I define it for you. And once I define it, it changes your perception of that concept. And once it changes your perception, it changes what you do. And once what you do changes, then your results will change. And then the money you make will change. It's actually called manifestation theory. Okay, so why does life reward you according to the accuracy of your definitions? The more accurately you define this, not in an academic way, but in a practical way, you can see all the things I'm defining for you today. It's not about academics. I'm not trying to prove to you that I'm a doctor, that I'm learned. No, it's about practical definitions that would change the way you do things, the way you go about your business and then making money. Okay, so what it means is the way you define something determines what you do. I'm going to talk about money now. I'm going to define money for you. You see the difference it brings about. So the way you define something determines what you do about that thing. Now, what you do about that thing determines the kind of results you get from that thing. And then the kind of results you get determines what the lifestyle you live. It's called what? The manifestation theory. Now, you can write this down right now. Let me share with you the manifestation theory. Manifestation theory says that your thoughts, T, lead to your feelings. Your feelings lead to your decisions. Your decisions lead to your actions. Your actions lead to your results. Your results lead to the amount of money you have. The amount of money you have lead to the lifestyle. All right, so whether you drive a Rolls Royce, whether you buy first class, whether you wear designers, that's a lifestyle. But that lifestyle is a manifestation of the thoughts you have. Everybody wants to live in a particular part of town. Everybody wants to live in the city. But your lifestyle is a function of the money you have. The money you have is a function of the results you have. The results you have is a function of the actions you take, what you do on a daily basis. What you do on a daily basis is a function of the decisions you make. So what's your decision? To come to this class? To learn? That's it. Now, your decision is a function of your feelings, the feelings you have. That's what determines your decisions. All right? And then your decisions, your feelings is a function of the thoughts you have, right? So that's the manifestation theory. I'm going to talk about that today, all right? So thank you. Let's quickly delve into deeper details of the spiritual laws of money. Okay, let's see. Daniel says, I am blessed. Techno Spark says, life does not reward according to my hard work, but according to the accuracy of my definitions. Okay, so did I define money for you? Money is a means of exchange. Money is a medium of exchange of what value? See, I made two definitions now. The first time I said money is a means of exchange. That's what most people know. But money is not a means of exchange. Money is a means of exchange of value. You must put that value. If you don't put that value, that definition is not correct, it's not complete. You know why? What it means is that money is a means through which you exchange value. So if you want to get money, it points you to the fact that you need what value. So I gave you the instance of the water. So the woman that sells this water or the company that manufactured this water, they already have value. Package the form of product, the product, which is this water. So when they need money, it is this product. So I took my money and then gave them. So they collected the money in exchange for this product. So the problem a lot of people have, why they are broke today, is they don't have any product, any service, any value. Even if you're looking for employment, you want somebody to employ you, what do you need? You need value. Because when you come to the organization, you must create value, you must deliver value. Whether you're a receptionist, you're a marketer, you're an administrative officer, you must create value. It is that value that you deliver to the company that now enables you to earn salary at the end of the month. So if you're coming for employment, the primary thing in your head is, what value can I bring to this organization so that they can pay me 100,000, so they can pay me 50,000, so they can pay you 200,000? And that's the positive mindset. That's the thinking that enables you to create and then make money. All right? Okay. I think I'm digressing too much. Let me know if I'm digressing too much. Type in the chat box. Am I digressing too much? Am I on course? Let me know. Am I digressing too much or am I on course? Shedak says, is a long one though. All right. So I've told you the three dimensions of reality. There's the spiritual, there's the mental, there's physical. I'm not going to talk about that again. I've already told you man is tripartite. So man has a spirit. Man is actually a spirit, has a soul, and then live in a body. So you have a spirit man. Your soul, well, is represented by the mental aspect. Right? I've talked about the three dimensions of the soul, which is the mind, which is the emotion, and then the will. Your soul has three dimensions. And then the physical is your body, okay? Now, I'm going to drive that down. Everything you see on earth, everything you see here physically exists in these three dimensions. It has a spiritual dimension, it has a mental dimension, it has a physical dimension. Let me give you an example. This phone, this is a physical phone. You can see it. This is a phone. Right? It's physical. But before this phone came to be, it existed in somebody's mind. Techno, the company, or the engineers, the designers, they conceptualized this phone first in their mind before they now built the factory and then manufactured the phone. Now, before the mental, there was a spiritual dimension. In Job 32 verse 6, it says, for there's a spirit in man, the inspiration of the Almighty, giving them understanding. I don't care whether you go to church or you don't go to church, what you worship or what you, there is a spirit, there's a supernatural dimension. So they probably, whether they're Christians or not Christians, I don't care about that, they would have downloaded the idea from a spiritual realm. But now, when it became an idea, they worked on it and they drew diagrams. It became an idea, which is the mental, which is the thinking aspect of it. And then they now built a phone. So when you're looking at this phone is a shadow, even though you can see it. This phone is what? A shadow, even though you can see it. Even though I'm holding the phone, it's a shadow. Yes, why is it a shadow? The substance of this phone is the idea in the mind of the designer. So if you steal this phone, you have not stolen anything. You know why? Because in the mind of the designer, he can make another one. And that is what it takes to be a wealthy man. A wealthy man is not about the millions you have in your bank account. It's about the millionaire ideas you have in your head. So when they take your money, when they take your car, you can create another car from the one that you have in your mind. It's inexhaustible. But it's a supernatural dimension of which is the spiritual. So today, again, I'm going to talk about it. If you're looking for money, money is cash. It's a shadow. Stop. There is a supernatural, there's a spiritual dimension of money. When you tap that supernatural dimension, you bring it into your mind, conceptualize into idea, then the money, which is the physical, will flow. Am I making sense? Okay. These things I'm teaching you, they are deep truths. So this class is what I teach in an MBA, and they pay $500 per hour to be in my class, but you're getting it today for free, right? Okay, Charles says, you're making so much sense. Fantastic, fantastic. All right, so that's what I'm telling you. So if you want 1 million, if you want 10 million, if you want 20 million, 1 billion, I don't care the amount of money you want, that is physical. We need to get to the mental level, which is a higher level. Then we need to get to the spiritual level, which is a higher level. That is what determines whether the money comes or not. So cash is what? A shadow. It's only poor men, it's only mad men that pursue shadows, right? Okay, so you now know, even this water that I gave you as an example is a shadow, is a physical water. Do you understand? It's a physical bottle of water. But before this water came to be, it existed in somebody's mind. Somebody conceptualized, created it. Okay? And then they made money. So one thing I need to leave this class today with is the fact that if you need money, money is a shadow. What are you creating in your head? And I'm going to give you the laws that will enable you to create that, right? Good or good? Good, 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 good. Good or good? Say to yourself, I am a millionaire, I am awesome, and then give yourself a high five. All right. Okay, so I guess you can see the slide. So now let's deal with money. You understand? Even though I've not been talking to you in parables, but of course I've been as explicit as I needed to be. But I want to delve into money in the next maybe 30 minutes today. But I'm going to discuss money in different dimensions. And the things I'm going to share with you tonight, some of you, if you apply them, I guarantee you that in the next 90 days, your life will be transformed. Even starting from today, I know that some of you said your life has already been transformed just by, you know, we've been in this class just about an hour. You understand? Okay. I'm a millionaire. I am awesome. All right, fantastic. So please make sure you do make this declaration twice every day for the next 30 days. Always say to yourself, when you wake up in the morning, say to yourself, I'm a millionaire. I am awesome. And then give yourself a fantastic high five. Then when you come back in the evening, whether the day was good, it was bad, don't worry. Those are normal things. Those are physical things. Speak to yourself again. I'm a millionaire. I am awesome. And then give yourself a high five. And then sleep and have sweet dreams. Then you can download spiritual ideas. You can dream dreams. And then you can manifest them. Right? Okay. So money also exists in three dimensions. Just like I said, everything exists in three dimensions. I have a mouse here. This mouse also has three dimensions. So you see, the thing is, you see, poor men have money. Wealthy men have a higher dimension. Poor men actually have cash. Wealthy men have a higher dimension of money, which is the idea and faith. Yes, that's a higher dimension. Because you know why? If armed robbers, we're not praying for them, then let's say armed robbers take your 1 million. And then you start crying, oh my dear, I'm dead though. Yes, you should cry because you're losing something, but you shouldn't cry for too long. Yes, some years ago, one of us came to my house and they took my Jeep. I bought that Jeep just like 3 months, and they came to my house and took the Jeep, and then it wasn't a big deal. Not that I didn't feel bad about it, but because I know what I did to make that money. It took me less than 3 months to make the money to buy another car. I'm not saying I was happy because they took it, but the thing is this, because I have the original. Just like somebody has a photocopy or the Z negative now, and then you print a picture out of it in those days, and you have the film, and then you print the picture, and somebody takes the picture. Yes, you cry because, or you feel bad because it's something that you took your time to make. But it's not so much because you know that you have the negative, you have the film. So you can go and develop another one. That's the same thing about money. And for a lot of us that have lost money, the reason why the money left you is because you don't have the mental and the spiritual dimension of the money. All right, okay. So, the spirit of money, please write this down. Write this down. The spirit of money is faith. The mental equivalent of money is idea. And the physical equivalent of money is business, which generates cash. So the spiritual equivalent of money is what? Faith. The mental equivalent of money is what? Idea. The physical equivalent of money is your business or the cash that that business brings. Now, the essence of this class is to point your mind away from cash and from business to faith and then to idea. Once you do these two, naturally the other ones will show forth, even though there are processes you need to take. But these two are more important. That's what I'm talking about, the spiritual laws of money today. All right, so faith is the spirit of money. Let me tell you something. America is a great country. Why is it a great country? The foundation of the founding fathers. The foundation of the designers of that country called America. Even though, well, current generations are eroding some of the values that America was built on, some of the values that America stood for or still stands for, some of them are being eroded. But if you get a dollar bill, if you get a dollar bill, there is something that is on every dollar bill beyond the head of the president or the people, whatever cool America that is there. It is called In God We Trust. Every dollar bill, get it, look at it. There is an inscription that says, in God we do what? Trust. That is what? An expression of faith, an expression of belief, an expression of absolute trust in the divine, in the supernatural, to make things happen in the physical. That's what you need to make. I'm not saying this in a religious kind of way. I'm not saying this for you to be a Christian, to be a Muslim. No. But for you to be wealthy in your life, you need faith. Faith is that belief that there is a supernatural dimension that controls all the things on earth. That is a divine intelligence. That is a supreme intelligence that knows everything. So when you step out of your house in the morning, there is a divine intelligence that controls everything that will bring you and put you in the right place at the right time. If you have that belief, you're on your way to being wealthy. Yes. And that is the greatest law you need to observe. Faith. Have faith. Now, faith is in two dimensions. Faith in God and faith in yourself. Yes. So you must believe in God. You must also believe in your own ability. So that's why I talked about, you can't call yourself a poor man. If you call yourself a poor man, that's an expression of your faith. That's who you are. It's not about claiming. It's not about saying you are when you're not. No, it's about a firm conviction in yourself that this is who you are. But beyond the firm conviction, you're going to do things in line with that. And I'm going to talk about that. So the faith is what now gives you ideas in your mind. Remember the scripture I quoted for you, Job 32 verse 6. It says, "For there is a spirit in man, the inspiration of the Almighty giveth them understanding." So let me give you an example. You run a business, or you want to start a business. Maybe you're a copper, maybe things are bad, maybe you're a service, whatever it is. You want to start a business. So first is for you to believe that this business is going to be successful, that this business, you'll be able to do this business and make money and help other people. For you to be able to believe that I can create products and services that are useful to other people. Believe it and continuously speak it that I'm a millionaire, I am awesome. And then before you know it, an idea drops in your heart. That is what that spirit connecting to the spirit of God and then giving inspiration. Okay? Now, when that idea drops, it is now based on the knowledge, the skills and competence you have that you can use to transform that idea into a business. It's when you transform it into a business that people can pay you. People don't pay for faith. People don't pay for idea. People pay for solutions. People pay for services. People pay for product. But that's the last. So you can have faith and still be broke. You can have idea and still be broke. But let me tell you the truth. If you have cash, you don't have faith, you don't have idea, the cash will leave you very soon. So what I encourage you to do is, you need to start from faith, believe in God, believe in yourself, not in a religious way, that's a different dimension altogether, but believe that there is something that controls, that makes everything beautiful in this time. And then believe in your own personal ability to make that happen, working with it. Remember, there's this scripture, it says, with God, all things are possible. With what? God, all things are possible. That word with is a conjunction, which means what? There's something. So it actually means man with God, man plus God, all things are possible. Yes. God alone, all things are not possible. There are certain things I don't want to say that religious people don't think I'm doing heresy. All things are not possible with God. He said with God. It means there is something plus God, all things are possible. For instance, God doesn't worship himself. See, God can't do all things, but God has a way to make all things happen. That's a different level of theology. So, but let me just give you an instance. If people don't want to worship God, God can raise tools to worship him. But that worship must come from something. So it has to be with something. Let's leave that one like that. Now, what I'm trying to let you understand is what you need, what faith. Then that faith is what gives you what? An idea. Idea happens in your mind. Now, based on that idea, you now go out and build a business. You go out and set up a shop. You go out and then do your business, whatever kind of business it is, shoemaking, dressing, cake making, restaurants, catering, all manner of businesses. Okay? Now, please write this down. Your spirit grows by revelation. Your spirit grows by revelation and inspiration. That's the only way your spirit is educated. By what? Revelation and inspiration. I won't talk about that. Revelation is actually a Greek word derived from the Hebrew word, apocalypse, a Greek word rather, apocalypse. Apocalypse means to show. So it's like a vision, it's like opening. So that's how your spirit grows, your spirit man. But your mind grows by education. Your mind grows by training. Your mind grows by impacting knowledge and information. So as I am teaching you now, I'm impacting knowledge and information into your mind. And then I'm giving you ideas of businesses that you can do. All right? Then your business grow by practically building it. All right? Good. Now there are eight spiritual laws of money that I need to share with you. I won't discuss all of them because of time, but I'm just going to mention them. Then next week, we're going to continue with them. Right? Are we following? Let me know if you're still here. let me know if you're following what I am teaching. I want to share with you 8 spiritual laws of wealth creation. I'm not going to discuss them in detail. I'm just going to mention them now, and then we'll tie the other class. So I'm over 1 hour, and I wanted this class to just last like an hour and a half. Okay? So type in the chat box if you're still with me, what you have learned so far, whether I've been blessed, whether I've learned something. Let me know in the chat box, and then just say from today, I will start looking for what the spirit of money, the mental equivalent of money, before the money will come to you. Okay, so I'm going to mention the 8 spiritual laws of money, and then next week I'm going to begin to discuss them. Good. All right, so still here. Yes, okay, thank you. I know you're still here. I can see the attendance. I know you're still here. But let me know what you have learned. Let's take a breather. Start. Let's do. Okay, let me mention the 8 laws, and I'll take a breather so that we can interact, okay? But let me know what you have learned, what you're going to begin to do differently in your business, starting from today, starting from this class, and then your life will be better. Because it's not just enough for you to come to this class and spend 1 hour, 30 minutes, and then something doesn't change. I want to be sure that next week, tomorrow, next year, there is something that will happen in your business, in your financial life, based on what you have learned in this class. Sapi says, from today I'll start hunting the spirit of money. Okay, well, please just know that spirit of money is faith too, so that I don't go outside and start looking for spirits. Spirit of money is faith. And how do you get the spirit of money? It's by study of the word of God. Yes, that's how you get the spirit. The spirit of money is in the word of God. It's not outside though. Let me tell you this, write this down. The Bible is the biggest, is the best, is the most important business book. Just telling you that, okay? Good. So if you're looking for the spirit of money, where do you find it? Is by the study of the word of God. What happens? Because God will give you a revelation during your study of his word that will enable you to translate that revelation into an idea for business. Today's class is spiritual, so let's take it easy. So you can see the 8 laws of wealth, 8 spiritual laws of wealth. Techno says, I've really learned a lot, sir, but the great one is poor people has money, rich people has dimensions. Okay. So there are 8 laws. You have the law of faith, the law of abundance, law of manifestation, impression of increase, law of harmony, law of immorality, law of energy, and law of gratitude. Okay, so like I said, next week, what I'm going to do next week is I'm going to take the first 4. So because I've laid this foundation today, I took my time to lay foundation today, okay? So next week, I'm going to discuss the first 4. Law of faith, law of abundance, law of manifestation, and law of impression of increase. Then in 2 weeks' time, I'm going to discuss law of harmony, law of immorality, law of energy, and law of gratitude. Okay? Good or good? So if you're going to be with me in the next 2 weeks, please write in the chat box. I'll be with you in the next 2 weeks. There are some other things I want to share with you today, but these are the 8 laws. So what I've done today is to give you the foundation to the spirituality of money. Money is more spiritual than you think. Yes. See, this law of immorality, I'll talk about it, but let me just mention it. Money is amoral. Money is not immoral. Immoral means a wrong moral. Immoral, I-M-M, then I-M, then moral. Immoral means wrong moral. Amoral, A is absence of, lack of. So amoral means absence of morality. Absence of morality is not the same thing as immorality. They are not the same thing. So money is amoral, means money is neither good nor bad. Money is neutral. That's what money means. I'm going to talk about it when I talk about love and morality. So what it means is, you see, money only makes you more of what you already are. If you're a fraudster, if you're a wicked person, if you cheat somebody, when you make money, you cheat people more, you defraud people more. The fact that you have money makes it more. If you're a wicked person, when you have money, you become more wicked. Money amplifies your wickedness. Yes, that's true. Money only makes you more of what you already are. Money money doesn't change anybody. That's the truth. They say, my husband doesn't used to sleep outside. He started having money. I started sleeping. It's lying. It's not the money that made him to start sleeping outside. He already had it inside of his heart, but because he didn't have money to afford the girls, that's why he wasn't doing it. So when he had money, the money brought out what was already inside. That's the truth. If somebody, for instance, I've encountered a number of staff, and then they come into the organization. When you're employing them, they prostrate, they bow down before you. It is poverty that is making them bow down before you. That's not their character. That's not who they are. By the time you start paying them, by the time they start making money, you see their true colors. So money is what? Amoral. Money only makes you more of who you already are. So now that you may not have money, it's the best time to cultivate the best moral standards, so that when you now have money, the money will bring out the best of you. All right? Good. All right. So, like I said, next week, I want to discuss the law of faith, law of abundance, law of manifestation, impression of increase. You don't want to miss these classes. You don't want to miss them. Then in 2 weeks' time, I'm going to discuss law of harmony, law of morality, law of energy. Money is energy. And I'm going to show you how money is energy. And they say the law of energy, law of conservation says energy can neither be created nor destroyed. It can only move from one form to another. So money can actually not be created nor destroyed. It moves from one form to another. So if you have 1 million today, that 1 million is energy. So it moves from one form to another. It moves from my hand to another person's hand to another person's hand. That's how it moves. And of course, we'll talk about love, gratitude. So let me know if you're going to be with me in the next 2 weeks. I'm going to run this series on the spirituality of money. All right, I'll continue being in all the classes. Thank you, Dr. J. You'll hear from me soon. Who is that? Who am I hearing from soon? Okay, thank you. I'll be available next week. Just join in. We'll join next week. Okay, we'll join you all. We're fantastic. Don't worry, the class has not ended. I still have a couple of things to share with you. I'm just telling you, I'm going to discuss these laws in 2 parts. So it's actually 3 parts. We've done first part today, which is introduction. So second part is the first 4 laws. We'll do that next week. Then third part is the other one. So there's something else I want to share with you today. Good. Fantastic. You know, that's our slogan. We repeat things. We say good or good. We say great or great. Don't go anywhere. I still have plenty of things to give you that you will learn. Okay. Thank you so much. We'll be with you all the way. Okay, so now I just came there to bring us up to date to what is going on. While we're dealing with the spirituality of money, there are still physical things in an environment, in our environment, that we need to understand. Now, it's for you to understand the kind of economy we have entered into. Thank you, Doctor. I'll always be with you. Thank you, my people. Thank you. I'm so excited. You know, the energy in tonight's class is just amazing. It's just impressive. Okay. So it's called the low-touch economy. And that economy is the economy occasioned by COVID-19. It's called what? Low-touch economy. Economy occasioned by COVID-19. There are 3 characteristics of that economy. One is that there is decreased close contact. 2, there is strict travel regulations and increased health awareness and personal hygiene. Why I'm discussing this, I want to share this with you, is so that any business you're going into now, you need to understand that people may not be congregating again. People may not be coming to your shop the way they used to come before. People may not be coming to your church the way they used to come before. So you need to factor that in and begin to think about adjustments you need to make in your business. One of the things I teach is, a couple of times, I see people teaching survival strategies post-COVID-19. There's nothing like post-COVID-19. Post-COVID, I'm not saying it will not end, but we need intra-COVID-19 survival strategies, because the effect, COVID-19 may end, but the effect of COVID-19 may be with us for the next 5 years. So you need to structure your business on how to live through this phase. And even beyond COVID-19, other things may still happen, right? So it's important you structure your business bearing in mind the economy we have entered into. It's called low-touch economy. And the characteristics are 1, decreased close contact, strict travel regulations, and then increased health and awareness and personal hygiene. So these are the things that are going to happen. So even in your business, people are more aware of their health. So can you leverage on that? Can you take advantage of that? Can that become an opportunity for you to do your business better, for you to make more money? How? By providing more value to people. Please, don't make money by defrauding people. Don't make money by cheating people. But you can make multi-millions as long as you concentrate on providing value for people. Let me give you an instance. If you now know that people are more aware of their health status, let's say you're a pharmacist, let's say you run it, even if it's not a health-related business, can you find a way to make people have value for their health? For instance, people come into your business and then you offer them different kinds of health drink. You offer them some kind of health advice. You can actually monetize it. When you're cooking food, you find a way of making your food more healthy. You find out that as you deliver that valuable, healthier food, you're going to be making more money. So what I'm saying is this. You can make all the money you need to make in this world by delivering better, improved products and services. Good, but please know that we have entered a low-touch what economy, right? Good or good, all right. So like I said, it's just for you to be aware so that you can structure and begin to build and create your business in the right dimension, in the right direction. Now, there are three essential businesses you can do. I'm just going to, you know, try to begin to wrap up with this. Essentials, anything that has to do with life. So this is for people who want to start new business. As you're listening to me, you want to start a new business, you want to you know, expand your business, you want to look for how to make more money, whatever it is you're doing. The kind of businesses you need to begin to go into now would be, one, essentials, which are businesses that has to do with life, saving life, health, and food. Any business that has to do with these three things will be profitable. But of course, remember there's a spiritual dimension, there's an idea dimension, okay? Then two, money. Because people, you know, because of the economic impact of COVID-19, people will look for ways of making more money, ways of saving money. So if you're a consultant, you're an accountant, you're a tax consultant, you're a coach, you can find a way for people to either save money or make more money. Then you'll be in business because you also make more money. Because as you teach them how to make money or how to save money, you also make money for yourself. Then products that are in demand, lifestyle products, sanitizers, face masks, face shield, all of those things, you know, infrared thermometers. These are in-demand products and services. Home entertainment, homeschooling. You understand? These are lifestyle in-demand products and services. You understand? Online services. Can you run online services? Can you help churches stream their services? Can you help people do their Zoom meetings? Can you help people do online programs? Are you an IT person? Can you help people develop websites? Can you go and learn these things? Can you go and learn programming? These are in-demand products and services. Can you do your events online? Can you take things online? Can you help people do things online? These are in-demand products and services. So this is just to give you an idea. If you want to start a business, you want to expand, you want to make more money, look at these three things: essentials, money, or in-demand products and services. And then you can create an idea, create a business, create a product or service around them. Right? Good or good. All right. So the last lap of the class, I'm just going to share with us just a few more things we need to do going forward, and then that will be where we end today's class. All right. Say to yourself, I'm a millionaire, I am awesome, and then do what? Take a high five. All right. Okay, so this class is going to end in the next couple of minutes. So what do you need to do? One, please join me next week. I'm going to send you an email, or maybe on my social media handle. You get the detail, whether it's holding on Friday, or sorry, on Thursday, or on Tuesday, right? Now, so the steps you need to take is, one, take action today. Those things you have learned, those things you have written down, make sure you act on them, and then make sure you get professional help. Make sure you get what? Professional help. Don't try to do it all by yourself, okay? You can see this slide. Don't be a self-help entrepreneur. Do yourself, maybe cheaper in the immediate, but it may be more expensive in the long run. Get professional help, get consultants, get coaches to help you achieve whatever it is you need to do. And I'm going to offer you two things, two ways I can help you going forward from today's class. Two ways. So if you want me to show you how I can help you, type in the chat box, say, show me, sir, how I can help you going forward in today's class. Type in the chat box, I'm waiting. All right. Good. I have to take a breather. All right. Okay. So let me show you two ways I can help you. I can help you going forward. Number one, we all need money. So there is a loan that is available. I'm a CBN licensed accredited consultant. So there is a loan that is available, and it's called CBN NYSAL AskMist loan. So it's available for entrepreneurs. You can access up to 10 million. And then I may not discuss the details, but those of you who are interested in being trained and getting the loan, you need to private chat. I'm going to share my number. So you need to get across with me. So I will share, tell you, because if you have the idea, if you have the spirit of money, you obey the laws, you still need money to bring that business to come to pass. So the central bank through NYSAL is already giving out loans up to 10 million. It's been on that will also help people. And then there's an online version of the training. So if you're interested in assessing the loan, you need to get in touch with me and I'll help you to do that. Then there's a program I have. It's called WhatsApp Instant Income Training. You can also get that program. It teaches you how to make money using your WhatsApp. You can make up to 150,000 every month simply by using your WhatsApp. So those are the two programs that I can help you. So for those of you who are interested, I'm going to share my number. Most of you already have my email, so I'm going to share my number so you can get in touch with me. If you want to be trained on the NYSAL CBN loan, then you need to talk about it. If you want to get 10 million, of course, that's what it is. We can also help you get that done. Then if you want to learn how to use your WhatsApp to make 100 to 300 thousand naira every month, then you need to get in touch with me so I can show you how that happens through a program called WhatsApp Instant Income Training. Right. So my number is up there, so you can take it, send me a private message on WhatsApp, whichever one you're interested in. Now let me also tell you, the AskMeet loan, which is the NYSAL loan, the cost of the training is 10,000 naira. That's the cost of the training. And when you private chat me, I'll give you further information about how you can get. It's the official CBN fee for the training. Then if you're interested in the WhatsApp Instant Income Training, it's 15,000 naira. That's the cost. So I don't have time to get into all the details of all of that. But for those of you who are interested, then we can talk about it. Then of course, next week, the class would also continue. You can see on your slides the steps to assessing the loan. The first thing is to get trained by an EDI. And then that is why you're paying the 10,000. And of course, we run an EDI and then we can guide you through the remaining 7 steps. Okay, good. Then the WhatsApp Instant Income Training is a 15-module online video course. Is learned on demand, is on the go. It teaches you personal finance, mastery, and entrepreneurship. It gives you my personal coaching and mentorship for free, and then it trains you on how to make money using your WhatsApp up to 100 to 300,000 naira every month. Okay, that's what the WhatsApp Instant Income Training does for you. So like I said, if you're interested, you get in touch with me. My number has been already shared. I've told you it's 15,000 naira for the WhatsApp Instant Income Training. Then the other one is like 10,000 naira for the NYSAL, the training for the NYSAL CBN loan. Okay, good. All right. So because of time, you know, I'm just running through the slides. So how is WIT delivered? Email, video, PDF, and WhatsApp. So how do you make money on WhatsApp? The training gives you what you need to do to be able to make money on WhatsApp. What if I don't want to use my correct contacts? The training shows you that this training is so in-depth. I don't want to talk a lot about it. Is it referral or network marketing? No, this is not referral. This is not network marketing. It's a training, but the training shows you how to use your WhatsApp to make up to 100,000 naira every month. And I'm the author of the training. So you can be rest assured that it's a no fluff game. Based on what I've taught you today, you should be sure that if I bring out the training program, it should be worth it. Okay. Do I need to create my own products to sell? No. Everything is already done for you. It's plug and play. Are there any other costs? No. Once you pay them 15,000 for the WhatsApp Instant Income Training, you get access to it. And then it shows you how you can use your WhatsApp to make 100 to 300,000 naira every month. You can just imagine, just on your WhatsApp, most of us on this class have WhatsApp and you've never made 1 naira out of it. Every day you spend money on data. But I cannot show you how you can use your WhatsApp to make money through that WhatsApp Instant Income Training. Let me say this again, it's not network marketing, it's not referral business, it's not investment, it's just a training that shows you how to provide valuable products and services to other people, and then you make money in exchange. Then those of us who need loan to fund our business up to 10 million naira, I'm not the one giving the loan, no, it's Central Bank that is giving the loan. But I am a consultant that will train you on how to assess the loan, okay? And then for that training, you have to pay 10,000. It's officially approved by CBN. That 10,000 is officially approved by CBN. I will have the online version. So irrespective of where you are, I can train you online on Zoom, on video, and all that, and you get qualified. You can assess the loan from Lagos, from Abeokuta, from Kwara State, from Ilorin, from Maiduguri, from Calabar, any part of Nigeria, you can assess the loan and do the training online for you. Just 10,000 naira. Okay? Good, all good. All right, so I have a challenge which is actually ongoing. So when you join the challenge, it's called WhatsApp Instant Income Training Challenge. And then the details of those who want to pay for either the training or for the loan scheme, you know, that's the details of the bank accounts and all that are there. All right, I'm just trying to rush so that we can get to the end of the slide. And then that is the last slide for today. So that's my contact. The phone number is there, the email address is there, the website, the Facebook handle is there. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I've been so glad, I'm so honored. You guys don't know how excited I am that I came back and then I was able to have this call today, to have this class today. So thank you, God bless you. Those are my details. I'm going to take another 5 minutes for question and answer. I'm going to open the phone. I'm going to open the microphone so you can talk to me if you want to talk. But if you want to ask questions, you can ask questions in the on the chat box. What if after the class you don't get the loan? Okay. If you don't get the loan, then you get the training. Oh, absolutely. Let me also say this. What we are doing is we train you on how to get the loan. But the training is worth a lot more than the 10,000. As a matter of fact, if you train with me, there is no reason why you should not get the loan, except if you don't follow the procedure. So I can actually guarantee you that you get the loan if you follow the things that I teach you. But again, let me say this, the loan is not for me. I'm not giving anybody loan. I don't have loan to give anybody. It is CBN, but CBN has selected some of us to train people and guide people on how to access the loan. You would have heard about it, CBN, NYSA Microfinance Bank. You can go and Google it or ask further questions. 10,000 Naira is the training fee. But your ability to get the loan depends on the consultant that trained you and guided you on the process of getting the loan. Over 35 billion of that loan has already been disbursed. So if you're interested, please let's talk and then you'll be able to, I can assist you to see how we can get that. Okay, good or good. All right, so let me share the number again. If you want to talk, just say unmute me so I can open the chat box and then allow, so not chat box now, I can open the microphone and allow you to talk. But please let me know if you have learned something in today's class. Let me know if you have been blessed. Let me know if we've been here 1 hour, 30 minutes, if the class was worth your time, okay? I'm gonna use another 5 minutes to just take questions and answer and those of them who wants to talk to us. Good or good? So, okay, take notes, says I really learned a lot. Okay, so let me see who wants to talk. We just have 3 to 5 minutes to end the class. Who wants to talk? If you want to talk, say unmute me. I will mute you. Okay, take notes back. Let's start with you. I said you should rename yourself so I know who you are. I've asked you to unmute, take notes back. So unmute yourself, then you can just talk to us briefly. 30 seconds. Your time starts now. Are you there?
Dr. Green, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, but you did tell us.
Can you hear me? Hello.
Yeah.
Okay, good evening, everyone. My name is June De Precious. I'm an event planner, event planning and decoration. My first time, and I'm glad to say I so much enjoyed the class and I really learned a lot, I won't lie. In fact, My sister was just looking at me like, I was attending the class so attentively. And I will tell you guys, Doctor, you are doing so well. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Precious.
I don't have a question for today, but many time I have question, I will chat you up. Thank you.
Okay. All right. That's great. Okay. That's Precious. She says she's an event planner and then she's learned quite a lot today. Okay. Fantastic. So who else wants to talk to us? I'll take two more people and then we'll end the class. If anyone, well, I'm gender sensitive. If anyone, I've asked it to your mute. So I guess you have a floor. Go on.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, go
can
on.
Hear you.
Yes, if anyone, please go on.
I've been following Doc since 2017, and I can assure you that if you continue to follow.
Okay, you can type in the chat box. It looks like your audio is not too good. Is it Barrister Ife Nwa? I'm not actually sure. How, is it Barrister Ife Nwa? Okay. One more person. I hope I'll get the guy. Sapi. I hope he's a man. So Sapi, I've asked you to unmute. Talk to us. What have you learned? How has today's class been for you?
Yeah, Doc.
Yeah, please go on. You have the floor. Doc, Sapi.
Good evening. Good evening. Yes, I said good evening. I greet you. I greet everyone in the house.
All right. Good evening, sir.
Yes, I would like to thank you very much for this wonderful presentation. It's awesome. I don't want to say it was awesome. I'm saying it's awesome because it's supposed to be like an anthem. You know, that those of us who attended the webinar should be singing now henceforth. So thank you very much. I wish to appeal on behalf of everybody that attended that if you recorded the presentation, you can share with us so that from time to time we'll play and remind ourselves. We've been jotting things down, but we still need to remind ourselves.